Hello.
People, hi.
Hey, it's me. I'm back. Doing something. I got something here. Yeah, a lot to talk about, a lot of things to say, but this video is kind of separate from that. You know, besides kind of the obvious, it's kind of been a while, and I'm kind of an adult man. Kind of, you know, here, I'm somewhere new, obviously. It's been a crazy 5 years. Be nice to say it was smooth, but it wasn't really. But now I'm here, and obviously a lot of things have been happening, you know. World's a crazy place right now. So I kind of felt like, you know, out of boredom, popping on and futzing around, maybe making a tier list of sorts. So to get main thing out of the way, I might make a Q&A after this if anyone, you know, watches this, is actually curious, is actually interested. But I think that making tier lists or maybe even like a few edited videos where just kind of talk about stuff down the line would be pretty interesting, pretty unique. It might be fun for me to do. I don't know if anyone would be interested in that. There's a lot of things I like talking about. I have a lot of the same interests as I do before, except Angry Birds is not one of them, obviously. I'm pretty sure that none of you are still really, you know, into it, and it's like, that's probably not going to be a video type that I make, because, you know, as of right now, it is literally not physically possible for me to make one of those, because I don't have those with me. They are, all those plushies are in a storage unit somewhere. We've been moving around a lot. I'm still located in Massachusetts, as I was before, but family's in Wisconsin, so that's kind of where my stuff is. So, but that aside, comment below if anyone would want me to make a tier list about, you know, talking, you know, more stuff. I mean, let me know if they want you to make a Q&A. I think I might want to do that. Obviously, it's kind of been a while, and I've left some people in the dark. A lot to think about if I really do this, but for now, it just kind of seems like something fun to do. And so right here, I got something I know that at least some people were interested in on the channel. That is a tier list of the Pokemon types. In the future, I'd have no problem, you know, tiering, talking about a lot of things. You know, Crash Bandicoot, Pokemon, Fire Emblem, I'm huge into right now. Kirby stuff, TV shows, SpongeBob, Community, regular show, all that stuff. I play a lot of games, League of Legends, Bloons Tower Defense. So I think I might just, you know, make some videos every now and then and just kind of, you know, to de-stress, kind of talk. This isn't like some gambit for ad revenue or something like that. I just kind of felt like popping on here and just, you know, making some stuff. But okay, so yeah, no, talking aside, I wanted to get into, you know, making this tier list about the Pokemon types and how I rank them. This isn't like a competitive tier list. This is just kind of like designs and how I think about stuff. Like, in the, like, just as a whole, like, design-wise, I think. Just, like, kind of collectively, what Pokemon I think have the best designs and just kind of ranking that. So, I'm gonna start out and hopefully we have some fun with this. I don't know if I'm going to do alphabetical. Yeah, I'm going to do alphabetical. And we are starting off with bug type. Pretty much kind of a meme back then. A really big meme. Obviously, stuff that's based off of, like, worms and shit is going to maybe be a little bit low. But honestly, if you kind of look at the stuff that's been coming out, like, this is, like, one of my favorite Pokemon of all time, Govantula. But, honestly, like, this is probably not the most popular opinion, but I'm just gonna do that. I'm gonna throw that right there. like, I remember even when I was a kid, I really liked bug types. Like, even if you look at the Gen 1 bugs, they're all pretty cool. You get Pinsir, Scyther. I'm huge on Pineco. Like, Grubbinline is sick. Butterfree's nice. Beedrill's nice. Ladian's, like, obviously there's, like, crap, like, Ladian. Like, I'm not huge on, like, Axelgore and, like, Burmy, Cricketune. These guys aren't like, fantastic, but, like, ever since, like, Gen 4, like, even there's still good stuff in Gen 4, like, got Ganmega. But after that, like, Scolipede, Crustle, Escavalier, Galvantula, Durant, Volcarona, Genesect, Vikavolt, Ribombee, Galissapod. Like, these three even, like, they don't miss. They've been great. So I'm putting that in S tier. I love me some bugs. Those are fun. Okay, this is gonna be a controversial opinion. Okay. Okay. Actually, man, this isn't actually gonna be that controversial. Yeah, okay. Looking through that, I have a different opinion than I thought I would, honestly. It's not like my go-to type, but just so many of the dual types are sick. Like, honestly, like, there's really not that many bad ones. Like, a few of the mono types are pretty trash, like Liepard, Thievul. Oh, Mighty Anion's even fine looking. Yeah, it's definitely A-tier. Dragon type. Yeah, you really can't. No, you really can't say anything besides just S tier. Probably cooler than bug types. Yeah, definitely. I feel like I'm not even that willing to cross a border and say that dragon types are worse than bug types. I am still trying to get people to watch this stuff and not think I'm a psychopath, so I'm gonna do that. So yeah, those are dragon types. Okay. Yeah, Flygon, Dialga, yeah. All this stuff. All these are like a few of my top favorite Pokemon all time in here. Electric type, okay. Okay. Very cool type. Very cool. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah, they're usually pretty much the best. So yeah. Yeah, I think that's fair. I think that electric types are sick, and I'm pretty sure most people do. They're always, like, incredibly fresh. Raichu, Jolteon's my favorite evolution, Ampharos is one of my favorite Pokemon of all time, Luxray, Electivire, Electros. This thing sucks, though. I hate this thing. Oh my god, that gen ruined so many evolutions. Like, they made a Corgi, which is great, and then they ruined it immediately. You had some promise, my dude, but went down the drain a little bit real fast. Unfortunate. So still S tier. Too many good things in there to say it's not. Okay. This is probably gonna be a hot take. Actually, this probably isn't even gonna be a hot take. Yeah, I'm gonna. Yeah. Yeah, that's. Actually. Okay, it's not C tier bad. But actually, there's some stinkers in here. Okay. Yeah. I'm gonna go C tier. Obviously, it's really strong, and there's some really cool Pokemon in here. Like Grimmsnarl's sick. Shinnok's pretty cool. Mimikyu. Bombi Primarina. This is really tough. But, like, a lot of the dual types are sick, but, like, Comfy, these things. This is the worst Pokemon of all time, probably. This thing. Nah, gross. I don't think I like that one. And I don't like Granbull, and I don't really like Florges, so... I think that C's a little harsh, but... Yeah. Okay, fighting type, S. S tier. But this is my opinion. I don't need to rank Dragon that high. I like Dragon a lot. These are all really close, but... I think fighting types are cooler than Dragon types. Fighting type has always been one of my favorites. Like, I'm gonna go look, and it's gonna be like... These ones are really weird. Gen 5 didn't have very good fighting types. But, like... Also, I hate Medicham, too. But, like... Oh my god, look at these! Look at this shit. Poliwrath, Heracross, Blaziken, Breloom, Infernape, Toxicroak, Gallade, Emboar, Scrafty. Yeah, S tier. Fighting types are amazing, and I always try and pick one up. Like, everyone's always complaining about dual type firefighting, but it's like, I'd rather take a dual type firefighting again rather than Rabbit. Ugh. Trash. Okay, and fire types. Okay, very popular. Probably my least favorite starter type, for sure. Yeah, like, Chimchar's the only one I'll go out of my way for. Okay, yeah, no, okay, that's A. That's an A-tier type, for sure. Fire is insane. I love fire types. They're always fun. It's always really cool to have it. Obviously, like, everyone's got the colors that they like, and it's like, my favorite color is orange. I wonder why my favorite color is orange. I wonder why. But, no, they're all, most of them are really cool. It's like, there's really not that many bad designs. Like, obviously, most of the bad fire starters, like Delphox. This thing, wherever that went. Where are you at? There you are. Ugh. Gross. Like, those are pretty bad, but, like, I don't really think there's, like, that bad of an early fire design, unless you're, like, in Mac Cargo. He's not even, like, that bad. He does what he needs to. He's, like, not strong, but he's funny. He's chill. He's like a slug. That's fun. I like that. Flying type. Okay, this is not gonna be very high up. That's for sure. I thought these were normal type. I literally thought they were normal type until now. This is really weird. I'm learning a lot. I'm learning a lot through reading about flying types. Shows that how little I actually use them. That's a C-tier type. There's some really good flying types. Like Talonflame's cool, Braviary's cool, Archaops. I like Swoobat a lot. Contrary to popular opinion, I know it sucks, but I love it. So, I might actually make... Maybe that's something that I'm going to make eventually down the line if I start editing. Might make a tier list about my top 10 favorite Pokemon that I know are stupid, but I still like them. But, like, it's so many just regular-ass birds. Like, Jumpluff, Latian, Noctowl, Spearow. It's like... It's just kind of... Also, these are the worst. I hate these things. So... That's a C tier. Is that even D tier? Honestly, it might even just be D tier. like, they're always so boring to use, too. Like, unless it's something really specific, like one of the super cool dual types, like having Charizards, even like Charizard's not that fun to use. Like, Corviknight was really fun. Like, the things that are like flying that are like even really fun and just have a cool type attached to them that just makes them not lame. I mean, most of them are just normal types. Yeah, it's like, she's like boring. See, I'm yawning. Think about normal type. Ghost type, which is next, and S, Bug Electric. There, I think there's like one dragon type that I outwardly dislike. Right, not dragon type, ghost type. Yeah. Yeah, there's literally one. Actually, I mean, I don't like this thing. This thing is dumb looking. Where are your eyes? Like, what's up with that? It's lame. Gengar. Goat. Top five Pokemon all time, Gengar. For sure. And this thing is, like, this? This is sick. Ghost type starter? Only bad ghost type is, like, Hoopa. So, yeah, no. That's an S tier type. Ghost types are so fun to use. Whenever I can pick one up, it's sick. Last thing I used was, I think the last ghost type I used in, I mean, I just used a Gengar. I played Ultra Moon, and I used a Gengar again, and he's still really fun. I used Miss Magius over the summer, and that was so fun. Chandelure. Everyone's always talking shit about, like Pokemon that are like inanimate objects, but it's like, it's Chandelure. Look at that thing. That's sick. That's one of the coolest Pokemon ever made. Like, no doubt. So that's an S tier type. Grass type. Oh boy. This is gonna be... I love grass type. But... Monkey, I love you. Monkey. Oh, this is gonna be tough for me. Actually, I have to put it in A. It's one of my favorites. Actually, I probably have to put it in B even. I'll put the variant C. I really like, actually, electric. Move electric down to grass. Overall, I have to put grass in B, which makes me really sad, I think. Actually, can I justify it? I can justify it in A. I can justify it in A tier for sure. I think it's cooler than fire type. I really like grass types. They always have that, like, probably overall, they're probably the best design starter type. Not my favorite, but really cool. Honestly, there's a lot of really sick ones. I can't really rate it that low. Like, I hate these things. These things I don't like. Obviously, Maractus exists, and Cherim is lame. But, like, it's like Sceptile. I can't say that's bad. That's a good type. That's a good Pokemon type. I like that. Okay. So that's going to be A tier. Ground types. Okay. This one I'm not exactly sure my thoughts on. Okay. Okay. No, yeah. S. Ground types are sick. Ground types are absurdly sick. There's so many bangers in this type. There's really, like, probably my least favorite thing on this list. Like, stun fist. No, this thing. Everything else is just fresh. Like, they take really good advantage of dual types. That's for sure. Yeah, that's an S tier type. That's for sure. I love ground types. Earthquake is broken. Everyone has fun with it. I think this is our first B tier type. I don't really like that many. I don't really have that much of a problem with most of these, but like, it's like, it's not something I had to line up for. Ice type. Like, usually I just do a water type with an ice move. Like, I really like Glalie. Glalie's my favorite ice type. I like Ice Cube. Ice Cube, which is actually better than Stone Drinner. If you didn't know that, it's actually much better. It's, you know, if someone's watching this, it's much better. Stone Drinner's trash. Articuno is really cool. Mamoswine's really cool. But Lapras is amazing. Lapras is a very sentimental Pokemon to me. So, that's a B-tier type, for sure. It's pretty cool. Like, the aesthetics are good, but, like, they don't really have that many, like, killers. Yeah, this is obvious. Okay, this is a... That's a D-tier type. It's worse than flying. Pretty obvious. I'm pretty sure most people agree. Beware, Braviary, Swellow, Wigglytuff. Well, like, those are all cool. But, like, you add this, and it's like... This thing makes me so upset. It's not even funny. I could like go on for like a 3-hour rant about how much I hate this thing. It's terrible. It's the worst. It's like this is where they put all the shitters. Except they're like Porygon and like Snorlax. Porygon Z is amazing. It's not even funny. It's so cool. But like, so many shitters in there. This is another type I'm in love with. It's poison type. Okay. Alright. Yeah, okay. Top of A tier. Yeah. That might be a little bit fast, but... I just... So many of Pokemon I'm just, like, obsessed with are poison type. I love poison types. It's just not even funny. Toxtricity. Roserade. Quillfish. Gengar, Victreebel, Tentacruel, Vileplume, Venusaur, Salazzle. Like, I think that, like, when everyone has those type combos they've been waiting for, like, I'm waiting for, like, the poison ones. Like, that's what I'm waiting for, because I think that combining poison with, like, other types is so sick. Like, I'm waiting on an ice poison type. I don't think they have one of those, unless I'm dumb. They don't. No, they don't. Like, I was waiting on electric poison for so long, I got this. And it rocks. And I was also waiting on a fire poison for a really long time, I got this. Which rocks. I love those things, those are sick. Poison types are so fun, and like... I'm like kind of a Gen 1 fanboy a little bit. Like, my favorite games are like 4 and 5. But like, I have a really big soft spot for Gen 1. And like... There's so many poison types in that gen, like Crobat. I love Weezing, I love Muk. I love the Nidos. It's great. This is gonna be a hot take. I'm pretty sure I already know where this is going. Okay. This is gonna be scalding hot. But that's a C tier type. There are so many bad psychic types. So many. Like, it's not even funny how many bad psychics they've had. And this is gonna, like, sound like a Gen 1er thing. I'm not a Gen 1er. Like, but it's one of those types where it's just, as time's gone on, the more they've added, the worse they've gotten, I think. Like, Gen 1 has a lot of great ones, like Alakazam, Slowpoke, super fun, Mew, Mewtwo. Like, there's even, like, Deoxys is sick, Ryu Nicholas is sick, but it's, like, Trash Line, Chingling's lame, Grumpig sucks, Chimecha, what's the point? Like, Gothitelle. Can we stop doing this? Can we stop doing that? Like, I don't want... It's like, we already had Jinx. It's just, like, a normal woman. And now you have another one, and it's just dumb. And BEM, Meowstic, lame. Hatchram's, like, okay. I'm fine with it. Gardevoir's sick. Zatu's sick. Lugia's sick. But, like, Upa, Oricorio's meh. Tapu Lele's meh. These are pretty cool. And Didi's lame. Calyrex is weird looking. All these dual types are cool. Medicham, meh. Meloetta's lame. Malamar's cool. Bruxish. You can never say that. This is terrible. This is an excuse. This is bad. No more of that. So yeah, that's... I don't like psychic types. Like, I like a lot of dual type ones. Like, these are all sick. These guys. All these are bangers. But like, just regular psychic types are usually so bad. Rock types. Okay. Okay. Rock type. Okay. These are pretty cool. I think I'm gonna put it in B tier. I think. Roggenrola, Regirock, Gigalith, Golem, Omastar, Aerodactyl, Tyranitar. I don't know. I think they actually might be... would they be A? I think they're B. I think they're pretty good. There's a lot of cool ones, but like... They're kind of rare, and some of them are kind of stupid. I like them. There's not a lot of them I don't like. But I don't feel like most of them are that great, usually. Nothing wrong with them at all. But they're, like, pretty cool. And this, I think, is a type that is really hard to go wrong with, unless I'm wrong. Okay. Actually, nah, that's an A tier type. It's probably better than it's better than fire. It's kind of hard to be lame when your whole design is that you just have metal on you, which looks absurdly sick. So yeah, no, a lot of these are sick. Magneton, Fortress, Scizor, Empoleon, Bastion, Lucario. Not that. This is an abomination, and we all need to accept that. Yeah, like, okay, now Gen 5 put, like, gas, like, steel types out. Like, look at these guys. That's a lineup. This is a lineup of steel types. That's great. Metagross, Skarmory, Steelix. I love Melmetal. I don't know if that's a hated opinion, but I love this thing. This is sick. Melmetal's super cool. I love me some Melmetal. And now! Aha, okay. Alright. Uh-huh. I'm just reaffirming my own opinions. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah, okay. And time to make a scalding hot take. S tier, the best type, the coolest type with the best Pokemon. I love water type. I literally always use a water type. Even now that I don't have to use Surf, I always pack one. Best starters. So many sick fossils. Palkia, Sharpedo, Ludicolo. Swampert, Kingdra, Mantine, Quillfish, Quagsire. They always look... There's, like, obviously... There's a lot of bloat, considering it's the most crowded type, but, like... How much bad stuff is there, really? Like, Inteleon, Alolamola, Basculin, Timpoline, Finneon. It's like, they have to have, like, regular fish, but, like... When they try, these are, like, some of the best Pokemon they come out with. Like, it's my favorite type. Like, 100%. Like, water's no doubt my favorite. Alright, so I think I'm gonna end it at that. This is pretty fun. I like doing this. I don't know if anyone else is gonna be interested or even watch this, but if you did, I appreciate it, and I hope that you liked it. And maybe in the future I'll try some better editing software, better mic, stuff like that. This is my class software for my online class, because, you know, end of the world right now. But I'd really appreciate some comments, you know, even suggesting what I talk about next, asking me if you want a Q&A, any other things, like comments on my scorching hot type ratings, anything else, really, honestly, like, you know, just reach out to me. What do you want to see me talk about next? And maybe I'll do this again. Maybe I won't. This is just, you know, an experiment, just kind of seeing how people feel. But, you know, if you watch through to the end of this, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. And, you know, stay safe, stay healthy, and hopefully I'll see you soon.